And I wish you a wonderful day with your children and with your families. This morning, our elementary chamber choir will be leading us with our music under the direction of Miss Cathedral. I thank our elementary chamber choir and all the many soloists who will emerge from the choir to lead us up here on the altar, and to alumnus Michael Fagan, who will be accompanying us today. I also want to thank Father Critch for being our celebrant, Brother Rick Fowler for, and the rest of the Basilica staff who are always so kind at accommodating us here. I want to thank all of the staff and students and parents for being here. We will have a reception in the Aula Maxima over at the school following the Mass for all moms and grandmas and parents and to staff who are available to come. Miss Millay has done a wonderful job of putting that together, and there's lots of delicious, wonderful food that we would really like you to come and eat and enjoy. Our chaplain, Mr. Ryan Butt, I want to thank him very much, to Miss Millay for all of her work, and also to the Rogers family and Bishop family who will be reading and leading us in the procession. Also at the beginning today, Miss Follett's kindergarten class will crown Mary here on the altar. This is a very special day for our kindergartens. Without further ado, we will begin our Mass, and I thank you for your focus and for your participation. Thank you all.
Please join us in our opening hymn, number 463A, Immaculate Mary.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And welcome, everyone, to this beautiful, historic Cathedral Basilica of St. John the Baptist. And I'd like to thank especially the kindergartens for the beautiful procession today to crown Our Lady the month of May. As we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, will we pray for all of our moms? And some of our moms are not with us, and some are here today, some are working maybe, and we pray for all of them today in our Mass. And as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us ask the Lord to forgive us for the times when we have not loved our moms as we should, when we have not loved each other as we should. Sometimes we can be very unkind by our words and actions, so we ask the Lord forgiveness. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. And we pray to the Blessed Virgin Mary. May the venerable intercession of Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, come to our aid, we pray, O Lord, and free us from every danger, so that we may rejoice in your peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. So please be seated now. We'll have our reading from Scripture.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Put on then, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, compassionate hearts, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing one another, and if one has a complaint against the other, forgiving each other as the Lord has forgiven you. So you also must forget. And above all, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony, and let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, in teaching and admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs with thankfulness in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The word of the Lord.
Please stand now for the gospel. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because a servant does not know what the master is doing, but I have called you friends. Because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. This I ask, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. There is not much stronger in this world than a mother's love for her child. There was a recent earthquake, and we know all about it, in February of this year, just a few months ago, at 4:17 a.m. Turkish time, 7.8 earthquake. We know what that was like. Struck southern and central Turkey and northern and western Syria. An estimated 14 million people were affected. The confirmed death toll as of now is 59,259. Now that's a massive number of people who died in Turkey and Syria. They're still struggling for that. After the earthquake had subsided, in one case when the rescuers reached the ruins of a young woman's house, they went in and found that she had died in the earthquake when the walls of her house collapsed on her. The rescue team leader and the rest of the team left this house and were going to search the next collapsed building. And for some reason, the team leader was driven by a compelling force to go back to the house of the young woman who had died. They began to take the rubble off the young woman, the wall, and suddenly the rescuer screamed with excitement, "A child, there's a child." The whole team worked frantically together, carefully removing the piles of rubble around her, and underneath the young woman's lifeless body was a 3-month-old little boy. It was all over the news, wrapped in a blanket. Obviously, this young mother had made the ultimate sacrifice. When her house was falling, she used her body to make a cover to protect her baby son. So she gave up her life for this little boy. The little boy was still sleeping peacefully when the team leader picked them up. There's not much stronger love in the world than a mother's love for a child. And Jesus said, "No greater love than this do we have to lay down one's life for another person." So today, in a special way, in our St. Bonds Mother's Day Mass, we pray and thank God for all of our moms, by birth or adoption, living or deceased, who have nurtured us through our journey of life. We also remember today in a beautiful way, as the kindergartens did, our mother, Mary, the mother of God who protects all of us, her children. We pray to her, and we pray especially to protect our moms. We celebrate mothers, you know, in May, the month of Holy Mary, because we feel that mothers are the strongest example of God's love for us. We first learn about love for them, from them,
They carry us close to their hearts for 9 months. They nourish us and protect us. In the beautiful first reading from St. Paul to the people of Colossae, the Colossians, we get the qualities of Christian love, of motherly love, compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, although we do test them every time, and especially forgiveness and gratitude. These are the qualities of our mothers, but also the qualities of each of us that each of us should develop as baptized Christians, as people of any faith tradition, whatever our faith tradition. Mothers show us that kind of love for us every day as they sacrifice their time, their energy to love and care for us. This is the very vocation of motherhood, caring for the needs of their children, laying down their lives for them, dying to their own self-interests, and doing loving, sacrificial things for their children every day. And God is like that too, because God is love. And Jesus says, God tenderly cares for us and lovingly picks us up when we fall. That is why we celebrate on Sunday Mother's Day. It's a very special day because we recognize that our moms, our mother's love is probably the closest example we have of God's love here on earth. It is the love that sacrifices itself over and over again. Today, on this Mother's Day Mass and on every day, we need to find ways to show our gratitude to our moms, to show our love for them as they have loved us. We pray today that for all of our moms, our living and dead, our birth and adopted, our grandmothers, any special mothers in our lives, we pray to the intercession of our Blessed Mother that God will bless and protect our mothers always. Amen. So let us stand now, and we ask whoever's doing the intercessions to come forward for our prayers of the faithful. And God, our Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear and answer all the prayers we have today in our hearts. We trust in your merciful love today.
Prayers of the faithful. The response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Francis, our Pope, Peter, our Bishop, and all our priests and ministers, that they may bring us closer to God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Holy Church, may it give peace and unity, and to protect it and prosper it throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all mothers, that they may be blessed in their love and care for their families, and that the Holy Spirit guide them with wisdom and love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gifts of life, of love, and of care from our mothers, stepmothers, grandmothers, and great-grandmothers, daughters, sisters, and aunts, both near and far, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Mary's humility and courage will serve as a model of all mothers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our school community, that is one we will seek God with our whole hearts and minds, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. In our prayers today, we remember all of our moms who have died. We pray especially for them that the Lord may give them eternal rest in the loving arms of Jesus, the Good Shepherd. And we pray for them. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the graces and blessings that you give us every day, especially the gift of our moms. And we ask our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our risen Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. So please be seated now quietly as we bring up our offertory gifts of bread and wine so that we will have our liturgy of the Eucharist, our second part of our Mass.
Hail Mary, full of grace. and blessed the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death. Amen. Gentle woman, teach us love.
Let us stand now. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise.
Let us pray. We offer you, O Lord, these offerings of reconciliation and praise, humbly asking, following the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may present our very selves as a holy and pleasing sacrifice to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all your saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's end, you have done great things and extended your humble mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, all the angels and saints, we pray and join with them in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his suffering and passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of our sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, the people of God, spread throughout the whole world, and bring her to the fullness of love, together with Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our Bishop, the clergy, and all your people. Remember all of our brothers and sisters, especially our moms, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Bonaventure, Saint Ignatius, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Christians around the world pray this prayer because this is the prayer that Jesus taught all Christians as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, has said to your apostles, peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your people, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us offer each other next to us a sign of the peace of Christ. Peace be with you all. Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I have a special blessing for all the moms. I would ask all the mothers in the congregation to please stand. Mothers and adoptive mothers and grandmothers, special mothers. So I'd ask the students who are seated, just look up at me. I want you to put your hand up because it's a blessing, right? So you put your right hand up in blessing over them. So put your right hand up. That's it, everybody. And I'm going to say a beautiful prayer of blessing. God of love, listen to our prayer. God of holy people, Ruth and Rebecca. God of holy Elizabeth, mother of John the Baptist. God of holy Mary, mother of Jesus. Bend down your ear to this request and bless the mothers of our families. Bless them with the strength of your spirit, they who taught their children how to stand and walk. Bless them with the melody of your love, they who have shared how to speak, how to sing, and how to pray to you.
Bless them with a place at your eternal banquet, they who have fed and nurtured the lives that were formed within them. Bless them today, now, in this lifetime with good things. Bless them with good health. Bless them with joy, love, laughter, and pride in their children, and surround them with many good friends. May they who carried life in their womb be carried one day to your divine embrace. And there for all eternity they will rejoice with their families and friends. This blessing and all grace, we pray, descend upon the mothers of our families. May all mothers, grandmothers, and other special mothers who have nurtured us and who have gone to their eternal reward rest in the peace of the risen Jesus, the Good Shepherd. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. And thank you very much. And I'd like to thank all of you for your presence here today, to thank the teachers, the administration, the staff, and the teachers, and everyone at St. Bonaventure's College. Is a truly wonderful place, beautiful school. And we pray that on Sunday you will treat your mothers very, very, very well. Okay, God bless all of you. And let us pray. Stand now for our final prayer. Having nourished us with heavenly food, O Lord, grant that, according to the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may serve you in pureness of life and glorify you with her in wholehearted praise, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless all of you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our own lives. Thanks be to God. And God bless all of you, and be safe. Thanks.
Please join us for our closing hymn, number 511.